Why do projectiles do what they do? Let's learn physics. We'll start with a couple guesstimations. Here's a cart, launches a ball vertically upward. It's spring-loaded, has a pin underneath that's attached to a string. Pull on the string to release the ball. So what's going to happen? Where's the ball going to land? If you haven't predicted what the ball's going to do, please stop. Think about it. Maybe go back. Here it is. Did you predict that? Listen to the slow-mo. Interesting. Horizontal speed doesn't affect it. Here's another one. This apparatus drops one ball and launches another one horizontally. That's the one that drops. It's got a big hole in it, but it'll fall at the same acceleration. And here's the one that is projected horizontally, and it goes a whole lot farther than the other one. As to release, you just pull up on that little lever like this. Make sure it's level, because we're trying to figure out which ball lands first, the horizontally thrown one or the dropped one. What's your guess? Pick one, horizontal or dropped. Ears first, listen for it, then we'll watch it. Huh, same result. Horizontal doesn't seem to affect the vertical. And does it feel like in Pittsburgh you're traveling 700 miles an hour horizontally, almost a straight line? How about in a plane? Can you tell you're traveling a constant 500 miles per hour? Horizontally? Everything acts normally inside unless there's turbulence, right? In a bus at a constant horizontal velocity, everything feels normal, right? So it doesn't seem that the X component affects the Y component. Why is that? Well, here's a basic trajectory. Your job is to figure out the forces acting on this thing. There's no air friction. What forces are acting at each point? Really, think about it. What forces are acting on that ball? If you said only the weight, ding, 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 you're correct. That's the only force acting on these things. Therefore, according to Newton's second law of motion, the net force is the weight, it's down, and the caused acceleration is also down. The X and Y are independent because the only acceleration is in the Y, because the only net force is in the Y direction. So looking at the velocity in the X direction stays the same the whole way through. There's no change. There's no reason for it to change. Newton's first law, objects tend to keep on moving at a constant velocity. But in the Y direction, oh yeah, that Y component definitely changes. And the XY combination velocity changes size and direction as it moves.
The X and the Y components of velocity, acceleration, and displacement are all independent of each other. Now keep that word in mind, independent.
It is because of that independence that we can split any projectile problem into two columns. An X column, where the acceleration is zero, the X component of velocity is constant, and one equation applies. It's pretty simple in the left-hand side. But the right-hand side, the acceleration is a negative 10 meters per second every second. You write down the values, use all the equations, all the kinematics equations on that right side. Recap. There's only one force acting in projectiles. It's down. Therefore, the only acceleration is down. Therefore, the X and Y are independent, and the Y is the only one that is affected. This bowling ball, that's what's happening in the X column. Constant speed, straight line. The Y column is a standard cliff problem. Therefore, use two columns in your solution format. Cool.